Hi guys, I'm James from iChongqing. Today I've come to a public park by the Yangtze River called Lingjiang Park. And what's so special about this place is that for many years the land had gone to waste, but then in 2019 it was beautifully landscaped into this public park where every day people both young and old come to enjoy themselves.
区城市管理局的那个工作人员，我姓钟，钟家伟。整个我们临江园呢，它是在2019年的12月建成对外开放的。整个我们游园呢，整体的面积在8200平方米。整个游园它整个的那个原貌的话，也是非常契合我们重庆的那个山地特色。它是坡坎崖的典型代表。
Something I really like about this park is how it brings out the topography of Chongqing. At the top, there's a viewing platform where you can look out across the Yangtze River. Below that, there's a pathway. Below that still, there's a children's play area and also a place where older people can come and use the exercise equipment. And right at the bottom, there's a basketball court that's open to the public free of charge.
整个我们游园在建成过后的话，它是在19年也被评为了我们重庆市最美的坡坎崖之一。那么当时呢，在全市的话，也只有10来个游园被评为这个奖项。所以说，我们整个临江园呢，它在建成过后的效果也是非常好的。There
are so many nice features in this park. I really like the artwork themed on care for the young and elderly. The trees and flowers bring color throughout all the four seasons, and the park is also very accessible. Over there, I could see plenty of ramps, and in the corner, there's a lift that can take you up to the main street above.
为什么以孝文化作为文化背景呢？它主要还是属于我们整个游园周边的一些群众啊，一些居民，它还是属于那种老年人的，比较多，还有就是常来这里玩的年轻人也比较多。那么新24孝的话，作为整个我们
公园的一个文化主题来说，也是非常契合整个周边的人群关系。我这个应该说，现在每天带小孙女儿，基本是来两次，每次都得一个小时左右。这样每天基本是两个小时多一点。我来了之后吧，我看这个地方人还是很多的，不管年龄大的、年龄小的，这个很多，说明咱们这个公园很吸引人。
In the past few years, Chongqing has taken urban beautification and a high-quality living environment very seriously. So now, wherever you live in Chongqing, there's a beautiful park right on your doorstep. And Lingjiang Park is just one perfect example. I'm James from iChongqing. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you again very soon.